today's session, we are going to discuss regarding the Neuman System Model. This system model is given by Betty Neuman. In this video, we are going to discuss regarding the part 1, that is the concept, the model, and the analysis of Neuman System Model. Even before we go on to the introduction to the theorist, we have to learn what is the specialty of Neuman System Model. So as I have told in my previous videos, that is in the video on how to easily remember Neuman System Model, how to remember the theorist and the theories, I have told that Neuman System Model is system stands for S, and so this model is for stress. Okay, so what is the specialty about this Neuman System Model? It is unique because it provides a unifying focus for approaching a wide range of nursing concerns. See, among all the other theories, personally, I have an opinion that Betty Neuman's theory is a very comprehensive theoretical model. It is very comprehensive because Neuman has taken into consideration all the factors which can affect a person related to stress and what is his reaction to the environment. Okay, so that is the speciality of Neuman's model. It provides a unifying focus for approaching a wide range of nursing concerns. It is based on the client's relationship to the environmental stress factor. So that is the speciality of Neuman's theory. Please remember, it is dealing with stress. How a person is dealing with stress and what is the interaction that takes place between the patient and between the environmental stressors, and what is the role of a nurse in taking care of this patient who is encountering a stressor. So that is what this theory is talking about. It is a very interesting model which is widely used in nursing, especially by students who are doing their post graduation in mental health nursing. Okay, other than that, also I can tell you that this is a very important question from exam point of view, because Betty Neuman system model is very frequently asked. So I think it is one of the most important theories what you study, especially for MSc nursing students. Now, as usual, let us start with introduction to theorist. Who was Betty Neuman? When was she born? She was born in the year 1924, and she belonged to a family of farmers, and she passed away in the year 2012. And when Neuman was around 11 years old, her father died of chronic kidney disease. But she has heard very often, she has heard her father praising nurses, okay, so which influenced Neuman's view of nursing, and ultimately she became a very committed bedside nurse, not only from her father's viewpoint. Along with that, her mother also was a rural midwife, thus her parents had a great deal in influencing Betty Neuman's entry to the profession of nursing, and then to have such a dedicated and commitment nurse in the clinical as well as in the academic area. Now, regarding her educational progress, we find that in 1947, Neuman took her diploma program from People's Hospital. And after that, in 1957, she did her bachelor's in public health nursing in the year 1957. Then she undertook her master's as public health mental health nurse consultant from University of California. And then she has received a lot of honorary doctorate degrees from various universities in praise or in recognition to, you know, the gifting of this system model to the profession of nursing. So we find her academic background starting from diploma program, doing her bachelor's, master's, public health and mental health nurse consultant, and then honorary doctoral degrees. Then what we understand from Neuman's theory, Neuman as a theorist, is she had excellent scope of working in all the areas of field. That is, first she proved herself as a very excellent bedside nurse, then she worked and as head nurse, and then as a private duty nurse. So she had very rich clinical experience. Coming on to later on, she entered into the community, and then she was involved in school and industrial nursing. She has handled a lot of counseling and crisis intervention in mental health settings. So we find her experience not only in the clinicals but also in the community. And then later on, after her master's, she enrolled herself as a teacher. Then she became an author, lecturer, consultant in nursing and interdisciplinary healthcare. So no wonder that Betty Neuman gave us a very comprehensive model of named as the system model, because we find she has a very rich experience not only in the clinicals but also in the community, plus in the academic background as a teacher, as a consultant, etc. Then she has the credit of being one among the first nurses licensed in California as a marriage and a family counselor. And actually, she developed her model in the year 1970. You know, that was that is how the model came into existence. Now, how did she, develop this model? Actually, it was because of her students. Her students asked her to prepare an introductory material exposing them to the physiological, psychological, socio-cultural aspect of a person. When they meet a patient, how to take care of that, all these variables. So her students were the people who actually requested Betty Neuman to prepare an introductory course to them, covering all these aspects of physiological, psychological, just an orientation. So it just started as a very small thing. But later on, she published her model in the Journal of Nursing Research. And after her publication, what happened is her theory, the model what she developed, did not stand only for her students, but you know, she made it available for both the clinical community as well as for education. So that is how her first model, it was written in the year 1974. She published her first edition of her model in the year 1974. And then, you know, subsequently in the year 1989, 1995, and then again she published the latest edition of her model in the year 2002. So we can say that she published four editions of her model, starting from 1974 till 2002. Then what made her, what was the push behind developing this model? Already I told you that it was one thing was from her students' aspect. But other than that, we find that she had her personal philosophy in life to help each other live, to support in development of a holistic system perspective. So her personal philosophy itself was an impetus to develop this system model. Second thing, we find that she drew upon her experiences, as we just now saw that she has a very rich experience in the clinicals, community and academics. Okay, so she drew upon her experiences, that is the clinical, the community and the theoretical perspectives of stress and system. And last, it's not only from her experience, also from various other theorists like Kaplan's level of prevention, Bergstrand, Dechardin, Cornu, Edelson, Emery, Laszlo, Lazarus, we know Lazarus model of coping, Celi's stress, Van Bertalanffy. So her theory was derived from all these things. That is, number one is she had her own personal philosophy. Number two, her own rich experience, that is in the clinical, in the community and academics. And number three is she based her theory on various other theorist works like Kaplan and Lazarus, Celi's, etc. So what was the title of the model? Now we know that the latest is the Neuman system model, which I presented in my first slide. But you know, what was the original title of the model? When she developed it at first, she named it like this: a model for teaching total person approach to patients' problems. It is a model for teaching total person approach to students. So she actually had that as her focus, that is to teach her students regarding the total person approach. It was just a teaching aid. So she named it like that. But later on, she named it as Betty Neuman's Healthcare System Model, a total person approach patient problems. But again, in 1985, she named it as final, and the name of the model is the Neuman's System Model. So that is about the introduction to the theorist. So we find herself excellent in clinicals, community, academics. Students were the source. She also had her personal philosophy. She derived her rich clinical experiences and works based on other theories. So now let's move on to Neuman System Model. So it is based on the stress and the reaction to stress. So what is this model talking about? This model explains about what are the various stressors and what is the reaction to those stressors with a philosophical basis that there should be wholeness, wellness, motivation, and energy and environment interaction. So this will become more clear in the following slides. So please remember, this is related to stress and reaction to stress. So it focuses on the response of the patient system to the actual stressor or to the potential stressor. I would like to tell that point. It can either be an actual stressor or it can just be a potential stressor. Now at present it is not a real stressor, but the patient is afraid. For example, risk for injury, it is a potential stressor. Okay, so it is a response of the patient to the actual or the potential stressor and the maintenance of the stability through intervention. What intervention? Prevention as intervention. We have primary prevention, secondary prevention, and tertiary prevention. So let me put it in a nutshell. This theory, it talks about stressor, it talks about reaction to the stressor, okay, and also it talks about how to maintain the stability and the wellness in the midst of these stressors, and what is the role of a nurse when taking care of a patient who is dealing with stressor. What is the role of a nurse? Neuman has delineated that the role of the nurse is prevention, primary, secondary, and tertiary prevention. So Neuman has said the word system. You find here it is a Neuman system model. Why did she give that word system? Because she believed system is a boundary. And this system can either be one individual, or it can be a group of individuals, or it can even be a number of groups or even a society. So to whom is this theory applicable? This theory is applicable to one person. It can be applied to a family. It can be applied to a community or even to a larger society. So system is a boundary which is delineating. It can range from one client till a community. Next, let us discuss about open system. So Neuman told that it is Neuman system model. We just now saw what is a system. Now there is a word which is called as open system. You know what is open system? Open means it is just the opposite of closed, is it not? There is an interaction. There is an interaction, or I can say in other words, there is a continuous flow of input, process, output, and feedback. So she believed that a human being is an open system, which means a human being is in always interaction with the environment. Okay, so there is an input, there is a process, there is an output, and there is a feedback. Okay, so it's like the patient is having an interaction with the stressor. Okay, and the stressor will be the input. Whatever is going on within the patient will be the process, and how this patient is going to behave will be the output, and again there is a feedback. Okay, so that is how it goes. Please remember, according to Neuman, it is an open system. Okay, so the meaning is all elements are in interaction, all the elements are interacting. Now, with this basic understanding, let us move on to the concepts of Neuman system theory. In your exam, you may get a question. Discuss or explain the concepts used in Betty Neuman system model. Okay. If you know the concepts, if you can understand the concepts, it is very easy to write the answer and score good marks. One more positive thing as a student I will tell you in studying this Betty Neuman's theory. The positive aspect is there are so many concepts in Betty Neuman's theory. Okay, so you will not be at loss because you have so many concepts. Okay, so you can just remember and very coolly you can write in the exam. Okay, so let us see. It's a very interesting model. So let us see what are the various concepts. So before even I'm going to tell what are the concepts, I want you to look into this picture or into the diagram, because this is the main concept in Neuman's theory. See, I have put a center circle and I wrote it as a basic structure. Okay, so this is not according to me, according to Neuman, there is something called as a basic structure. Now, in this basic structure, we all have, according to Neuman, we all have certain circles or lines around us. Okay, what are these lines? These three lines which I have put here, it is not a solid line. It is a dashed line, or in other words, it is a dotted line. What are these lines indicating? They are called as line of resistance. They are called as line of resistance. So in the center is the basic structure. Around the basic structure, we have concentric lines, which is called as line of resistance. Now comes another solid line. So far, basic structure was a solid line. Line of resistance is a dotted line. Around that, we have a solid line again. What is that solid line indicating? That is the normal line of defense. That is normal line of defense. I will explain each thing. Then again, around the normal line of defense, we have again a dotted line. And what is that dotted line? That is flexible line of defense. What are these lines? What is these lines of resistance and line of defense? I will explain to you in the future slides. But just remember this message. This is one human. Okay, if I'm going to take one client, like for example, if it is me, okay, within me, there is a basic structure. There is a basic structure within me. I'll tell you what is a basic structure. Within me, there are lines of resistance. And I have a normal line of defense. And around me as a buffer, I have a flexible line of defense. So let us see what are these lines and how it is going to fit into the patient in the following slides. So first is the basic structure and the energy resources. I told you basic structure is the core. It is a center. Okay. It is what is present within an individual. That is called as basic structure or the core. So this basic core has a lot of survival factors which is common to the species. What do you mean by common or basic survival factors? We all have our own basic survival factors, like maybe it is the temperature, maybe it is the digestive system. We all have certain things which are very common, which are very common to all of us. At the same time, this basic structure has certain things which are unique. It is not common to everyone. It's certain things are unique. Shall I tell you an example? Color of the eyes. Color of the eyes is unique. We all have a certain color, but all of us need not have the same color. Some of us have, it may be it is blue in color, for some it is going to be black in color. Okay, so the color of the eyes, the color of the hair, the genetic makeup. In all these cases, we are unique. You and me are not the same. But there are certain things in which we all are having the same survival factors. Like for example, maybe it is the organ, maybe it is the organ system. So what is there within a patient, within an individual? That is called as basic structure. So it is a central core which is common to the species. Number two, this includes the system variable, the genetic features, the strength and weakness of the system parts. Regarding variables, I will explain. For example, what are the basic structure? The normal temperature range, the genetic structure, the organ. Psychologically, I have my own, you know, ego or superego. Okay, so such things are also there. So baseline characteristics are also there. Unique characteristics are also there. So, what is ultimately needed in this basic structure? There should be a stability. temperature means there should be a stability. Then only you say that if it is going to be within 98.6, or let me say even little bit wider, till 99, I can say that, okay, the temperature range is normal. But beyond that, I'll say that the body is not in a state of stability. It is losing its equilibrium, which is called as homeostasis. Okay. So, what is the basic structure requirement? There should be stability. Stability of various variables, which I will be discussing in the following slide. And when will the stability be there? When the amount of energy that is available is exceeding the amount which is used by the system. Say for example, if I have only 1 hour time. Okay, I have 1 hour time and I have to complete say 100 pages in writing. Now what happens is, my psychological aspect, my physical aspect, everything will be stressed up because the time available is less. Now let me put it in the other way around. I have 1 week time. I have 1 week time and I have to write 100 pages. Comparatively, I will be more stable in the second aspect. Why? Because the amount of time that is available is exceeding the amount that is going to be used. Same way, in all our human system, what Neuman is telling us, the amount of energy available, if it is going to be higher, then what is being used, then automatically stability will be there. So if I have to be stable, the energy which is present should be greater than what I am using it. Then only stability will be there. Otherwise, patient is going into instability. So that is what is called as homeostasis, where there is a state of balance. There is a state of balance between what goes as input, what comes as output. If everything is in a balance, then fine. This basic structure is in stability. So let me tell you once, basic structure is the core. It is within the patient. It is within the client. What is this basic structure containing? It contains common factors. It contains unique factors. Common factors for survival. Unique factors may be in the form of genetic makeup, etc. Okay, any psychological ego, etc. So we all may be different. What is the goal of basic structure? Stability. When will there be stability? Only when the energy available is greater than what is being used, there will be stability. The other name is homeostasis. Next, let us discuss about the client variables. Now, within this basic structure, there are a lot of variables. Let me repeat it. Within this basic structure, there are a lot of variables, 5 variables told by Neuman. What are the 5 variables? Number 1, physiological variable. I hope these are self-explanatory. Physiological variable deals with bodily structure and function. Psychological variable is going to deal with mental, emotional process. That is psychological variable. Socio-cultural variable is related to social and cultural expectations. See, when you assess a patient, you cannot say X and Y are having same disease and they should behave in the same way. Why? Because X may be different from Y with respect to physiological variable, psychological variable, socio-cultural variable, developmental variable, and even a spiritual variable. So what Neuman is trying to tell us is, when you do an assessment to a patient using Neuman's model, look into all the variables, assess all the variables, okay, because all of us are unique. My socio-cultural development may be different from what this is yours. Developmental variable may be different in age, maybe in experience. We are different. Okay. So that is why Neuman says that assess the 5 variables, physiological, psychological, sociocultural, developmental, and spiritual. Let me add a note here. Spiritual variable was only added at last by Neuman. And what did she mean by spiritual variable? Spiritual variable is present in all of us. For some of us, we acknowledge spirituality. Whereas some of us, we don't acknowledge it. And some of us develop our spirituality while others know. It permeates all the other variables. This is according to Neuman. She believed that spirituality is permeating all the other variables. First, it is used by the mind and then by the body. For example, if I trust in God, if I have complete faith in God, I have peace of mind. I have happiness. This peace and happiness are first experienced in the mind. And later on, when I deal with others, it is exhibited by the body. The way I communicate, the way I show love and affection. So that is what is meant by the five variables which we should assess using Neuman's theory. So one concept is basic structure. Number two, client variables. Number three, okay, in client variables, again, what is the goal of a client variable? It is harmony and stability. So this I have already discussed. Each of the variables should be considered when you are assessing the patient. Next, let us discuss about flexible line of defense. Where is the flexible line of defense? The outermost circle is called as the flexible line of defense. I'll show you the picture. This one. Okay, this outermost layer, which is in a dotted circle, is called as flexible line of defense. What is a flexible line of defense? It is an accordion-like mechanism. See, this is an accordion. Okay, it is an, you know, it is like a buffering thing. Okay, it is like, you know, it comes back to normal. Okay, it's like a cushion. Okay, so it is what Neuman said is, it is like an accordion-like mechanism which is surrounding and protecting the normal line of defense from invasion by stressor. Something what we take extra, you know, to protect ourselves from stressor. Say, for example, daily exercise. Okay, daily exercise, a person who does daily exercise may be, you know, physically more fit than another person who doesn't have any illness but who is not doing any exercise. That exercise part, you know, that is a cushion which is protecting you from certain stressors. Maybe another example is maybe a very good balanced diet what you are taking. Okay, you are very conscious about your diet. You take very well balanced and high nutrition diet. That is actually a cushioning effect which is protecting you from the invasion of other stressors. Again, Neuman was very careful in saying that flexible line of defense is dynamic. Okay, if you are exercising, say for 2 months, doesn't mean that your buffering system is always good. Only if you continue that throughout, it is going to have an effect. So it is dynamic. Some of us we do, some of us we don't do for some days. Okay, so that is why this flexible line of defense is dynamic. So that is completing the first line. What is it? It is the flexible line of defense. Why in a dotted line? Because it is dynamic. It keeps on changing and it is protecting this individual from the invasion by the stressor. So that is about flexible line of defense. The second one is normal line of defense. Normal line of defense is an adaptation level which is developed over time and it is normal for a particular individual. Okay, that is what is representing, you know, what the client has become over time. Like for example, normal line of defense. One example which I can give you is bowel pattern. Okay, elimination pattern. For one person, okay, this bowel movement may be, you know, twice in a day may be normal. Whereas for another person, once in 2 days may be normal. Okay, that is because, but the system is stable. They don't have any other problem. It is developed over time. Okay, so the what is normal for one person need not be normal for another person. That is called as normal line of defense. Okay, so which is a normal line of defense? The second one. So the solid line. Just below the flexible line, we have the solid line. That solid line is normal line of defense, which is being developed over time. And that is what is determining what is health and what is illness. Okay, the deviation from health to illness is determined by this normal line of defense. I hope it is clear. Two lines we discussed, flexible line, cushion, normal line developed over time. The third one is line of resistance. This is activated when stressors have penetrated the normal line of defense. That is here, if you're going to see here, this is the line of resistance. So I told you that it is in a dotted line. Okay, it is normal line is here, line of resistance is within. Okay, so this is the line of resistance. When is this line of resistance going to come up? When the normal line of defense is invaded by a stressor. Okay, when this normal line of defense is broken, then the line of resistance will get activated. Like for example, when a person is developing an infection, you know that bacteria has entered into the body. Okay, so the normal line of defense is disrupted. Now what will happen? The line of resistance within a person is going to get activated. What are they? Maybe your WBC starts to increase. Maybe your ESR, erythrocyte sedimentation rate, starts to increase. Okay, so you find all the inflammatory cells starting to get increased. So all these things are showing that the line of resistance is activated. So what is line of resistance? It gets activated when the normal line of defense is invaded by a stressor. So those are the lines. So three lines, I'll just tell you the keyword. Flexible line of defense, cushion. Normal line of defense develop over time. Line of resistance gets activated when the normal line of defense is going to be penetrated and the line of resistance is getting activated. Next, let us discuss about the input and the output. Why should I talk about input and output? Because it is a system. In a system, especially open system, there is an input and there is an output. So the matter, energy, information exchanged between the patient and between the environment entering the system or leaving the system at any point in time is called as input-output. So this is very simple, entering and leaving the system between the patient and between the environment. Now we are going to discuss about stressor. This is the main aspect in Neuman's theory, stressor. What is a stressor? According to Neuman, any phenomenon which penetrates the flexible line of defense and the normal line of defense, resulting in either a positive or a negative outcome. Okay, see, let me tell you, Neuman did not see stressor as negative. She felt always that stressor is neutral. It is how you perceive it. It becomes either a positive or it becomes a negative. Okay, now for example, if I perceive a particular stressor as positive, for example, a small examination anxiety, okay, examination anxiety can be taken as a positive stressor because I will study only when there is some anxiety. But you know, negative stressor is when that examination anxiety is going to ruin me down, when I'm not able to study well, when I'm not able to concentrate, you know, my autonomic nervous system is highly stimulated and I'm not able to do anything, then fine, it's going to be a negative. So who is deciding it? Okay, it is the patient. The perception which is going to determine whether the stressor is positive or negative. So in stressor, mainly, okay, Neuman has said that there are three types of stressor, okay, from the environmental, three types of stressor. What are they? Intrapersonal stressor, interpersonal stressor, extrapersonal stressor. Intrapersonal stressor means sometimes everything around me will be perfectly okay. Okay, but the problem is within me. Okay, there are some people when everything is fine, they always find something to be sad about. They always find something to, you know, cry about. That is because of intrapersonal stressor. It can occur within the client system. Maybe it is the emotion, the feeling, the autoimmune responses. All these things can be put as intrapersonal stressor. Stressor is within me. That is intrapersonal stressor. Maybe in some psychologically disturbed persons or even with patients with personality disorders, you know. So in such cases, maybe the stressor is from within. It is from their perception. That is called as intrapersonal stressor. The second one is interpersonal stressor. It's very self-explanatory. Interpersonal, it is not within, it is outside the client system and it is very proximal to the system. Proximal means it is very near to me. Maybe it is the stressor is my, you know, the role expectation in the family, role expectation in the place where I work, or it may be the role expectation of my friends or my relatives. You know, it's not only role expectation, anything which comes, example is role expectation. It can be any problem which occurs with another individual, within proximal to me, near to me, someone who is in my circle, maybe my work environment, my family environment, my friend environment, etc. You know, so that is called as interpersonal stressor. The next one is extrapersonal stressor. What is extrapersonal stressor? It occurs outside the client system, but it is at a greater distance from the system. It is not my family, my work, my friends, my relatives. No, it is something, you know, far away which is affecting me. Say, for example, it is a social policy. It is some, you know, job or financial pressure. I think that is the best way to say. Financial pressure can be an extrapersonal stressor. Okay, it is not just because my employer is not giving leaving me. It's not because of that, but there are a lot of other problems where there is, you know, debts and such things, which is called as financial pressures, or any social policy, health policy, which is affecting me as an individual, is called as extrapersonal stressor. So let me tell you, what is a stressor? A stressor is something which is penetrating the line. Which line is penetrated? Flexible line, number one. Number two is the normal line is also penetrated. So that is stressor. It is neutral. It depends on the perception. There are three types of stressors: intra, within, inter, between, proximal people. Extra personal, it is outside, but it is having a greater distance from the system. Next is the environment. Neuman has also talked in her theory about the environment. Environment can either be internal or it can be an external environment which is influencing the patient. Okay, whichever is influencing your client, let it be internal or external, positive or negative influence, that becomes the environment. Internal is it exists within the system. As I told you before, stressor is present inside. Same way, environment can be internal. That is, all the forces within the boundaries of the client system is called as internal environment within the system. It is not from outside, it is from within the system, what type of environment a patient is having. Number two is external. It is not stressor, it is external environment which exists outside the system. Now, this external can either be interpersonal or it can be extrapersonal. Just now what we told, interpersonal or it can be extrapersonal. Extrapersonal is, you know, the outside thing, social policy, health policy, etc. So what environment you're maintaining with your friends, with your family, with your society, in your organization, etc. Okay, outside the system boundaries. Usually we have heard only about internal and external environment, but in Neuman's theory, there is something very interesting which talks about another environment called as created environment. Okay, created environment. This may be something very special only to Betty Neuman's theory. Okay, Neuman has told that there is third environment called as created environment, which can be intra, inter and extra personal. It is developed unconsciously by the patient and is a symbolic of system wholeness. That is, unconscious mobilization of all the variables, particularly psychological and socio-cultural variable. The main purpose of created environment is to maintain the integrity and the stability of the system. Okay, so what do you mean by this is created environment? Okay, not much explanation is given, but this is what is being told. The goal of created environment is to maintain the stability. Goal of created environment is to maintain the stability, okay, to maintain the wellness. What is this created? Okay, if any stressor comes to me, for example, if there is a very rude remark passed against me, okay, in which I have not done anything wrong, okay, but a rude comment is being passed to me, there is a usual way how I handle it. Okay, there is a normal way how we all handle it. Okay, maybe intrapersonally, I may, analyze the situation. I may think, who passed the comment? Is it true? Is it really relevant? Okay, to whom did that particular person tell? Interpersonal, maybe I will talk with my friend or with my family members. The usual way how I deal with a stressor in order to maintain the stability. Suppose in a created environment, the usual way is I just ignore it. Okay, or my friends are suggesting me to just ignore that rude comment. Okay, I take help from others and then I find myself psychologically stable. I'm not going to further conflict. Because that is a created environment. I know how to take care of that particular problem. Okay, so that is what Neuman has told here. Now, with this example, please try to read this and see. It is developed unconsciously by the client. It is an unconscious mobilization of all the variables, especially the psychological variable and the socio-cultural variable. Okay, talking with your friends or family members. Purpose is what? To maintain the integrity and the stability of the system, to promote positive stimulus towards health. So that is the goal of created environment. So it's actually simple. Okay, Neuman's theory, when you're studying, remember the stressor. Once you get the word stressor, you can write intrapersonal, interpersonal, extrapersonal stressor. Number two, environment. Environment, internal environment, external environment, created environment. Okay, next is stability. What is stability? From the beginning, I was trying to tell that the main goal of system model is to maintain the stability or to maintain the equilibrium or to maintain the harmony. Okay, so a state of balance or a state of harmony where the client is able to cope up with the stressor. That is the point. The client is able to cope up with the stressor either to retain the optimum level of health or to maintain or attain the optimum level of health, preserving the system integrity, which means the system is still in harmony. The system is not affected. The patient is able to deal with the stressor. That condition is called as stability. The other concept is degree of reaction. What is the degree of reaction? It is a system's instability resulting from the invasion of the normal line of defense. So I told you that the stressor is invading. Number one, flexible. Number two, normal line of defense. As the stressor is invading, there is definitely a reaction which is done by all of us. Okay, any client will have a degree of reaction. So degree of reaction according to Neuman is the amount of system's instability. The instability which happens when a stressor is invading is actually called as the degree of reaction. Next is, she has used a lot of words, okay? Entropy. What is entropy? A person where the energy is depleted and the system is moving towards illness or the system is moving towards death. Let me tell you one single word. Moving towards a negative aspect is called as entropy. Okay, or what to say, it is moving towards illness or moving towards possible death. Okay, that is called as entropy. The next one is neg entropy. What do you mean by neg entropy? Here the energy is conserved and the system is moving towards a positive side. Say for example, towards a higher degree of wellness or towards stability. When this system is moving towards a higher level of wellness, you call it as neg entropy. Shall I tell you? Entropy means the system is moving towards illness. Neg entropy means the system is moving towards wellness. Okay, illness, entropy, wellness, neg entropy. Next is reconstitution. Reconstitution is trying to restore the balance. Okay, trying to return and maintain the system stability. Okay, returning, that is already there is a degree of reaction. After the reaction, the system is trying to come back. You know, it is trying to regain its stability. That is the return and maintenance of system stability after a stressor reaction, which can result either in a higher level of wellness or in a lower level of wellness. So the system, how much it is trying to regain the stability, is called as reconstitution. Again, wellness and illness. Wellness means there is harmony. Illness means there is insufficiency. Okay, that is a very self-explanatory word. So, wellness means it is in harmony. Illness means there is no harmony. Next, this is the most important part as nurses. What is the intervention? Prevention is the intervention. So, intervention modes for nursing action and determinants for both client and the nurse into the healthcare system. So, what is the intervention? Nursing intervention? Prevention. So, what is the nursing intervention in the care plan you are going to write? Prevention. What prevention? Three levels of prevention. I hope all of you will be thorough about this primary, secondary and tertiary prevention. So from Neuman's model also, she has told about these three words. Primary prevention is before the system is reacting to a stressor, before the, you know, strengthening the flexible line of defense. That is what we usually say, is it not? Primary prevention means, I think we all have those words, health promotion and specific protection. That is a key word of primary prevention. Neuman also has told, even before a stressor is occurring, even before a stressor is, you know, affecting me, okay, I try to take some measures to, you know, strengthen my flexible line of defense. That is what I gave you the example. Exercise, well-balanced diet. Okay, so that is all primary prevention. Immunization, even hand washing, wearing a mask. Now in COVID-19 period, wearing a mask is actually coming under primary prevention even before the virus is attacking this normal line of defense. Second one is secondary prevention. We all know secondary prevention means what? Already the stressor has attacked the line of defense. Okay, and now only way is to strengthen the internal line of resistance. I told you when the line of resistance is being stimulated, for example, I told you WBC, ESR is increasing because there is infection in the body. How can I strengthen the line of resistance? I may have to take antibiotics or antivirals or antifungals so that my line of resistance is going to be strengthened and I'm able to overcome that stressor. That is when the system is reacting to a stressor, strengthening the internal line of resistance, that is secondary prevention. Okay, so this is the line of resistance. So let me tell you, primary prevention is this flexible line of defense is strengthened. Okay, now secondary prevention is already the stressor has invaded the normal line of defense. So the only way I can do is to strengthen the internal line of resistance. Okay, if secondary prevention is not successful, then the system stability will not occur. Just now we discussed reconstitution means coming back to normal, coming back to the previous stability. Okay, so if this is not successful, then reconstitution will not occur. Sometimes even death will occur. What is tertiary prevention? Already we have treated with secondary prevention strategies and now we are going into tertiary prevention. That is mainly the goal is to support the client and to add energy to the system, okay, or reduce energy needed to facilitate reconstitution. That is secondary prevention as such is over. Now we are going to support the patient. Maybe you say after a patient, when a patient is getting discharged, we say them that you have to take 1 week of bed rest. Maybe you have to take more fluids. You have to avoid maybe high fat diet, or depending on the condition, we say a lot of things. That is actually tertiary prevention, where you are trying to support the client. Even you can take an example as an amputation. After an amputation, what are we doing? Prosthesis, helping the patient to learn with the to learn to walk with prosthesis or to walk with crutches. All those things, you know, that all comes under tertiary prevention, providing support, okay, and providing adding energy to overcome that particular stressor, or you know, reduce energy to facilitate reconstitution, reducing unnecessary spending of energy in certain psychological issues. You can teach the patient how to, you know, overcome that particular situation. That is called as tertiary prevention. The goal is to maintain wellness and to protect the client for reconstitution. Okay, now these are the main concepts which are being discussed in Neuman's model. Now, this is perfectly the original model which was given by Betty Neuman in her model. See, if you try to read this, you will be very quick to understand what is her various concepts. We started with basic structure with variables. How many variables? 5 variables. Then I told you about the lines. Okay, line of resistance, normal line of defense, flexible line of defense. We also discussed about the stressor. Stressor can happen at any time. Okay, it can be intrapersonal, interpersonal, or it can be extrapersonal stressor. So that is what is given here, intra, inter, and extrapersonal stressors. I told you what is a reaction. I told you that when a stressor is invading, the system's instability is being, seen as degree of reaction. Then we discuss something called as reconstitution, that is to trying to maintain the balance. Trying to maintain the balance and coming back is called as reconstitution. Then Neuman beautifully, she has depicted the nursing intervention in her model, primary prevention, secondary prevention, tertiary prevention. If you're going to look further in detail, you can see this line, okay? Primary prevention is targeting which line? Flexible line of defense. I hope you can appreciate this arrow mark. Primary prevention is targeting the flexible line of defense. Secondary prevention, you can see the arrow mark going till normal line of defense and entering into the line of resistance, because secondary prevention means already the line of defense is being attacked. So we have to take care of the internal one. Then we have something called as tertiary prevention, where she has written about readaptation, a reduction to prevent future occurrences, etc. And so that is also helping in reconstitution. Let me tell you, students, it's very simple. Okay, Betty Neuman's theory. If you want to remember Neuman's theory, just remember one word. It is a stressor. Okay, it talks about, it's like a story. Okay, it talks about a patient or a client who is dealing with a stressor. Okay, this stressor can either be, now first, even before I go to stressor, I should first talk about the client. This client is a system. This client is an open system. Now, you know what is open system? This client has a basic structure. with five variables. We all vary in that five aspect, five variables. We all have a line of resistance within us. We all have normal line of defense, which we have developed over time. And we all have a flexible line of defense. Hopefully, we all should have a flexible line of defense, which is going to protect us from the stressor. Stressor can be either within, intrapersonal, interpersonal, extrapersonal. Environment can either be intrapersonal environment, that is internal environment. It can be external environment. The third special one, created environment. Goal of created environment is to move towards positivity or to move towards well-being. Then I have to know there is something called as reaction. Whenever a stressor is entering a client, the client will react. There will be some instability. That is called as degree of reaction. There is something called as reconstitution. That is coming back to the stability, coming back to that equilibrium, coming back to that previous stability. That is called as reconstitution. Then, what is the role of a nurse? Prevention. That is the intervention. What is prevention? Primary, secondary, tertiary. Simple. That is Neuman's, you know, Betty Neuman system model concepts. It's very simple. Talk about the story of a client. What all lines are there in a client? Talk about the story of the environment and the stressors, what is coming. Talk about the story of a nurse, what she is going to do. Isn't that simple? So that these are the concepts in Betty Neuman's theory. So the same thing what I told you now. This is what is model. So concepts are over. Now you will have to write about the model. Draw the picture and write the explanation. See, I will only read the keywords. Client is an open system. Client has variables, the five variables. The client system are having certain lines. There is a line of resistance, there is a normal line of defense, and there is a flexible line of defense. The three lines. Stressors, intra, inter, extra, personal stressor, which can come from internal, external, and created environment. When stressor is breaking, which line? When the stressor is breaking, the flexible and the normal line of defense, the line of resistance are activated. If adequate energy is there, the system will be reconstituted. If adequate energy is not there, what will happen? The system goes into instability. Simple. So write like that for exam. Neuman system model. If they are asking concepts, write down the concepts. If they are asking you to explain the model, draw the picture and explain these specific points. Now we are moving on to the last section, strength and weakness. So in strength and weakness, the one of the greatest strength in Neuman's model is, it was designed actually for nursing, but it can be used even by other health disciplines. So very few theorists are like this, where even other disciplines can use our nursing theory. One another person is Rogers' theory. Martha E. Rogers' theory, we should have a great credit because her theory is used by other disciplines. She was a nurse. So same way, this theory can be used by even people from other health disciplines. So what is the strength in this point? Strength is when everybody are using this model, there will be a consistent approach to patient care. But the problem is, it doesn't differentiate what is the practice of nursing. Because it is for everyone, what is that unique thing which is kept for nursing? That is a big question mark in Neuman's theory, but it's not a very big problem. It's a wonderful model which can be used in nursing profession. What are the strength of Neuman's theory as such? As I told you, it is very flexible. Please remember, it was developed for his students, education. Then it went to clinicals. Now it is used in administration and even in practice. Okay, so in all areas, this theory can be used. It is equally applicable. In the first beginning slides, I told you, this client system can either be one person or it can be community. So it can be used for anyone, individual, family, group, community, or aggregate. The model is logically consistent. When you read the theory and when you look at the model, it's perfect. Whatever is explained is only put in the picture. Primary prevention, very good. It is used to, we can use this theory as a primary prevention nursing intervention as for health promotion. And once it is understood, it is simple. I sincerely pray and wish that now this Neuman system model is going to be simple for you. Okay. It's relatively simple once you have understood it. Now let us talk about the weaknesses of Neuman's theory. There are many critics who say that there is need for further clarification of terms, especially terms like intrapersonal and extrapersonal stressor. She told that intrapersonal stressor is very proximal and extrapersonal is somewhere, you know, social policy and health policy. But the critics still feel that little bit more explanation is needed in her terms. Same way, the three defense lines, some of them they feel that it's still not clearly explained. And why to complicate with so many levels of resistance? That is another one critic in Neuman's theory. And Neuman has made one, have you all noticed it? In the beginning slides, I told you that there is something called as basic, that is the core and energy resources. Okay, energy resources, she has not spelled out exactly what energy resources. That is a critic. Okay, so she has not spelled out exactly what energy resources. If she has spelled out, then we as nurses could have concentrated more on that particular energy resource. So again, that is a critic, or from an analytical point of view, this will be there for all theories. Okay, we'll talk about the positive, we'll talk about the weaknesses. So it's just an analysis. Then it's a very comprehensive view. That is a positive aspect of Neuman's theory. Then she has used the word entropy. You remember what is entropy? Entropy is moving towards illness. Okay. As such, when you take entropy is a word which is talking about a closed thing. It is moving towards illness. But Neuman has told that it is an open system. Again, from an analytical point of view, they are asking, in an open system, why are you using a word called as entropy? Okay. So that is just an analytical point of view. So this completes the part one video. Okay, so in this video we have discussed regarding the various concepts, and we just saw a brief introduction to the theorist, the various wonderful concepts which was given by Betty Neuman. We saw what is her model, and we also discussed about the analysis of the theory, that is the strength and the weaknesses of the theory. So in my next video, I will be in part two video, we'll discuss about the assumptions of Neuman system, the propositions and all the other things. Okay, so whatever is left out will be covered in part two video, and maybe in part three video we'll discuss about how to apply this Neuman's theory in clinical practice. So I would like to thank you all for your great love, encouragement and support, and I sincerely pray and wish that this video is going to be useful, especially to all the nursing students who are watching this video. So thank you very much. Thank you.